Welcome back again. Now we are going to discuss about various number systems. Generally, there are four different number systems: decimal, binary, octal, hexadecimal. As name indicates, decimal system uses 10 symbols starting from 0, 1 till 9. This is the number system which we use in our day-to-day life. It's kind of a benchmark thing. Everyone knows it. So now the binary uses two symbols, 0 and 1. The octal number system uses 8 symbols, 0, 1 till 7. Whereas the hexadecimal number system uses 16 symbols starting from 0, 1 till 9, then 6 alphabets, A, B, C, D, E, F. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9. Then A is 10. B is 11 till F is 15. So if you have a 15 apple, so in hexadecimal you will say I have F apple. This is the flavor of different number systems. So let's start from decimal and we will discuss each one. So for decimal system, base is 10. What we mean by saying base is 10? Let's explain this through an example. So the number 231. So we know from the extreme right start, this is the ones area, this is tens, this is hundreds. So ones can be written as the power of 10, 10 raised to 0, 10 raised to 1, 10 raised to 2. That's why we are calling this as base 10. 10 raised to 0 is 1. Please note that every number raised to 0 is 1. 1000 raised to 0 is 1. 1 raised to 0 is 1. So 10 raised to 1, 10. 10 raised to 2. 10 raised to 2 is equal to 10 into 10. So it's 100. Now if you multiply by this, you will get this number. 2 into 100 plus 3 into 10 plus 1 into 1. So you will get 231. So this is what we are saying, that the decimal system has base 10. Now let's talk about the binary. The binary has base 2. So for example, now we know a binary number. Forget about how it comes, that all we will discuss in the coming videos. For example, I have a binary number. As we have done in decimal system, from the extreme right, I am starting putting 2 as base, 2 raised to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is the value of 2 raised to 0? 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Now again, if you multiply by this and add up, so 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 0, because we are multiplying 0 into 60. Again 0, then 4 plus 2 plus 1. So if you sum up this number, you will get 231. So corresponding to 231 in decimal system, this is the binary number. In the coming videos, we will discuss how to convert decimal to binary and binary to decimal. That all we will discuss later. So for the time being, explaining how the base works in binary, decimal, octal and hexadecimal. So now let's check octal number system. In the same way, for example, I know octal number 347. So the base is here 8. So 8081. 82. This is 1, this is 8, this is 64. So if you multiply 3 into 64 plus 4 into 8 plus 7 into 1, again you will get 231. So corresponding to 231 in decimal system, this is the octal number. Now coming to hexadecimal system, in the same way, for example, I know a hexadecimal number E7. So here the base is 16. So 16 power 0, 16 power 1, this is 1, this is 16. If I multiply E into 16 and 7 into 1, E in hexadecimal is 14. So 14 into 16 plus 7 into 1, we will get 231. So corresponding to 231 in decimal, E7 is the hexadecimal number. So now we have found four different types of number system: decimal, binary, octal and hexadecimal, and how many symbols are used in each system and what are the base of each system we have discussed. In coming videos we will discuss how to convert decimal into binary, decimal into octal, decimal into hexadecimal. We will work with the same example. We will convert 231 into this binary number, and we will convert 231 into this octal and 231 into this hexadecimal number, and we will see how it works.